Hi children, welcome back. Hope you all are fine and doing good. Okay, and enjoying these all videos. Okay, and even you are enjoying your holidays also. So in this today's video, we are going to discuss about another one new chapter, that is rooms in a house. We all have a house, right? That house may be a very big or small, but we have house. So in common for one house, there will be some types of rooms where we do the particular things, the particular works. So let us see what are the rooms are there in our house and what we do in that particular place, and how those rooms are going to be helpful for us. Okay. So usually we know that every one of us, we have either our own house or we have the rent house. But there will be a different types of rooms will be there in the both types of house, that may be rent or that may be own. So in that commonly we have some rooms which are used for the common purposes, and it is useful also. So for example, first one we have like bedroom. You know that for what purpose we use the bedroom. Children, now I am doing this video in the bedroom itself. You can see my cot, you can see my bed. Isn't it? Because I have fixed my board here, so I am using this room for this purpose. But other than this, we use the bedroom for sleeping. So what else will be there in the bedroom? We will be having the cot, like bed, and we will be having the bed sheet on that. We will use the rug and woolen to cover our body. So we will be having beds in our bedroom. We use our bedroom for sleeping purposes, especially we have separate bedrooms. For example, if we have our family members like a grandfather, grandmother, and uncle, aunt, and mother, father, for all mother, father, one bedroom will be there. For us, like for me and my sister, one bedroom will be there. And grandparents, for grandfather and grandmother, there is a separate bedroom. So like this, all will go for their bedrooms to sleep, to take rest. For sleeping purpose, bedroom is used. And next one is kitchen. What do we have in the kitchen? In the kitchen, there will be attached another room. We call that one as a storeroom, where we can keep all the eating grocery things in that storeroom. And in the kitchen, we will be having the utensils, vessels, and the stove, cylinder, and all eating items where we can cook the food. My mother, my sister, grandmother, sometimes father, grandfather, these are also going to cook. Even our brother, elder brothers will be there, they are going to cook the food. I know in many houses only the ladies will cook, but in some houses both will cook, gents also and ladies also. So the kitchen is used for cooking the food. Then after cooking the food, next room we have bathroom. We know very well for what purpose bathroom is used. Bathroom is used to take bath. Usually, we will take bath once in a day. We should take bath at least once in a day. In some special cases and in some houses, they will take bath two times. Morning and even the night while sleeping also, they will take bath. And in summer season and all, usually we take bath three times or two times because it will be too hot. We feel to take bath by the cold water. So in the bathroom, we use for taking bath. We brush our teeth, we wash our face, hand wash. So like this, these all things we will do in the bathroom. Next, we have the living room. Living room means what? Every one of us have the separate bedroom. For some bedroom, they will be attached to bathrooms. We take bath there, we take brush there. And after that, to cook the food also, we have the separate another one room. One or two members of our family will be busy in the cooking food for one time or two times for a day. And then bedroom is separate, bathroom is separate, kitchen is separate. and there will be a one room where we all family members will come and sit together. We will spend some time together there. So that room is called as the living room. Usually in the living room, we have the showcase, we have the some ideas like some memories. We will be having hanging the photos, we will be hanging the wall clock, we will be having hanging the wallpaper, and some show items we will be keeping. And we have the sofa set, we have the divan set, and we have the TV, newspaper. So usually these all things will be there in the living room. In the living room, of course, all the members can meet in the living room in a particular time. That may be morning time, that may be evening time, that may be afternoon time, that may be some of us, we have the habit of watching TV together. Some of us have the habit of talking together. We will sit, enjoy, we will talk about holidays, we will talk about study, we will talk about the health, we will talk, make the phone calls to our other relations. So like this, for all this purpose, we need the living room. So this living room contains these all materials, and where we all family members can sit and together, and we can enjoy, take fun, make fun of that time. Then we have dining room. What do you mean by this dining room? Even in your school also, we will be having the dining hall, because the strength, number of students will be more compared to the houses. So we will be having one big hall. So we call that one as a dining hall. In the house, usually we will be 4 to 5 or 5 to 6 members, hardly. Then we need space there. So usually we eat there. We will be having one dining table. We'll be having some, yes, of course, more than 80% we all have the dining tables and in our dining hall. Then whatever is cooked in the kitchen, the place may not be the sufficient, and we need some we want to sit together and we want to have the breakfast, lunch or dinner. Usually breakfast and dinner can be done with all the family members. And about lunch, we will be going outside and all. Lunch, may not be possible to sit together and eat. But breakfast and the dinner usually we do in dining hall, that is together. All family members are going to sit together. So in the dining room, we have the dining table. Whatever the food is cooked in the kitchen, we bring the mother, sister, grandmother, they will bring that food and they will keep on the dining table. We all together serve ourselves, or mother is going to serve for us. So we all can have fun, talk, and nicely we can eat. This is what about the dining room. And even other than that, next also we have some rooms and some simple steps how to take care of our house. That one we are going to discuss in the next video, children. So I will end this video by this. And before ending, I would like to give you one homework. Children, you have exercise part in your textbook. At least solve half of that exercise. Otherwise, you can write down answer for one question, that is, what are the rooms in a house? You can write these all rooms. It is there in this video. You can write these all rooms. And while writing, take care of your handwriting, and you should write in a four-line notebook only. That you should take care of your handwriting, and you should have the practice of writing every day at least one page copywriting. Okay, I hope you will do this one, and let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.